Hello everyone, this is Walter Fate, and I'd like to welcome you back to another Reddit story video. A little while ago, I covered Pro Revenge, and I got a few comments asking me to check out Nuclear Revenge, so that's what we're up to today. Nuclear Revenge is a subreddit for any story about extreme revenge, especially if it goes way beyond the initial offense. Rules do say the stories have to be true this time, by the way, but that doesn't mean they are, of course. I like this rule that says no stories of nuclear attacks. Apparently enough people thought that would be funny that it needed a rule to stop them. Well, let's just jump into it and see what kind of stories they have here. Nuclear Revenge Stories from Reddit. You break my glasses? Have fun with your remaining ear. TLDR at the bottom. For context, I was tall for a 5th grader, but I was a friendly giant type. I wasn't violent, though I had anger issues, they usually came out as verbal berating of whoever had attracted my wrath. I was the kid that made teachers go to the counselor in tears. But that made me an easy target for bullying. They wanted a reaction without the threat of violence. As for the incident, it was during gym class. We were wrestling and it was my turn. Since I was in a weight class of my own, I won almost every time. Some of my bullies didn't like that. So two of them wrenched my arms out from under me while I was in a match, and a third did a John Cena slam onto my face, breaking a $200 pair of prescription glasses. Probably should have taken them off, at least that's what the bully's parents said when they refused to pay for them. My mom decided to punish me by taking my personal savings. I was going to buy a PS3 at the time to pay for the new ones. I was pissed. This was completely ridiculous. They assaulted me and I was being punished for it. That was 3 years of saving down the drain. So I went up to the kid the day after and I told him to meet behind school to settle this. He and his two cohorts came and I told them what happened. They realized how much money I lost and that 5th grade honor rules were clear that a behind the school fight was necessary. So I told them it was 3 versus 1. If I won, they would pay me back. If they won, I'd never eat them out for the shit they pull in the future. So we went at it. I rammed the main kid into the wall and headbutted him, causing a bloody nose. He punched me and I got swarmed. I was busted up pretty bad, but so were they. It ended when the leader tried to bear hug me to the ground. In my adrenaline-fueled rage, I bit him. More specifically, I bit his ear, tearing most of it off. Everyone froze at his scream of pain. We ran to the nurse, temporarily calling truce as you do in this situation, and we got an earful about fighting. The mother wanted to press charges, but the bully admitted to instigating the incident, so it was a case of self-defense. We all got suspended. The bullying never stopped, but when it got too much, I would begin to walk forward, and no matter who it was, they'd run for the hills. My nickname for the next 2 years till I moved was Feral. TLDR, bullies break my glasses, we fight in an honorable duel, I bite his ear off, everyone knows not to get into a fight with me, ever. You know, I like to think I'm pretty tough, but I don't want to fight anyone who I think might bite my ear off either. I'm not even sure this is actually revenge. The revenge he tried to get was beating them up and getting money, but I don't think he showed up with the intention of biting anyone. It turns out fighting 3 people at the same time isn't really that easy, and I'm not sure why he calls it a duel in the first place. Crazy shit, though. Let's read another story. Destroy my mailbox? How about I end your football career? So I lived in a small suburb in the Dallas/Fort Worth area of Texas most of my young life in the 80s and 90s. In this town, high school football, edit American football, where everyone smashes into each other like a bunch of savages, was like a local religion, and the booster club was like the mafia, even going as far as buying off the cops to let their precious football star kids run amok across town, usually pinning the blame for their shenanigans on bad kids like myself. I wasn't popular. In fact, I was quite the opposite, because in a small town in the mid-90s, a nerdy, grungy metalhead with no interest in sports such as myself stuck out like a sore thumb. My home and property was often the subject of vandalism, much to me and my dad's annoyance. The most annoying thing was having to buy a new mailbox, like every few days, because it would be smashed into bits. One day, me and a couple pals were poking around a scrapyard when I found a metal pole with a flat piece of metal across the top. Ideas started churning in my head. I dragged it home along with some other metal scraps and welded together a 100-plus-pound invincible steel mailbox and cemented it to the ground, where our flimsy stainless steel one used to be. My dad high-fived me for my ingenuity and the welding skills I learned in shop class. Over a week went by and no mailbox incidents happened, but at school there was a huge buzz because one of the star football players seriously fucked up his shoulder. He had a football scholarship waiting for him when he graduated, but that was ended as his injury left him unable to play ever again. I never put two and two together until my dad got a summons to court for the malicious injury of Jockey McFucknuts. It turns out this jackass was the one destroying my mailboxes. He would have his friends drive him past my house in his car at high speed while he smacked it with a baseball bat while he leaned from the passenger side window. When I installed the solid steel mailbox, he tried this same shit and, well, bye-bye shoulder, bye-bye football career. The lawsuit against me and my dad never got off the ground. The parents dropped it when my dad's lawyer successfully wrangled a change of venue due to threatening answering machine messages from the local booster club. I felt a little bad at first as I never intended to destroy this guy's dreams for the future, but now that I look back on it, he brought it all on himself for being an entitled scumfuck. The author goes on to share a picture of the base of the mailbox. The actual box had to be replaced with a standard one eventually. Yeah, you know what? The guy wants to go around wrecking people's property all the time. Fuck him. I don't know if I sound a little harsh here because he was in high school, but even if this got him killed, and it could have, I'd probably still say the same thing. Let's read another story. Here's one where the revenge goes as planned. It's up to you whether to believe it or not. Don't mess with a dude in a suit. Originally, I posted this under Reddit Pro Revenge, but came to realize it more nuclear. So this happened years ago when I was in high school. I had to wear a suit to school one day. I forget why, but that's not important. I was at lunch and this kid, let's call him Bruce, walked up behind me, put his hand on my shoulder, and told me I had a nice suit. I knew he had wiped something on me because he is a known douche and liked to try to prank people. As he walked away, I turned to a friend of mine and asked if I had something on my shoulder, to which he said Bruce wiped Cheetos on me. I walked over to his crowd of friends and said, "It might not be today, and it might not be tomorrow, but I'm gonna get you back and I guarantee it will be 100 times worse." To set some context, my friends know from prank wars that I am not to be trifled with. I'm also the kind of guy who's cool with almost anybody, so I have a vast and varying array of friends, especially at school. It didn't matter the clique, I knew someone in it. I ended up with people tracking him in every class he was in, as I spent the next 2 weeks trying to figure out how I would exact my revenge. Finally, the day comes that a friend tells me at lunch Bruce has left his backpack unattended. A light bulb goes off in my head and I knew exactly what I wanted to do. We walked by the backpack and my friend picked it up and then handed it off to me. I took it to the cafeteria bathroom, then put it in the toilet, opened it up, and dropped a mighty deuce inside. I wiped up and stuffed the papers in the side pockets. I took the backpack out and left it next to the toilet. I walked out like a champ. Here's where the story gets really good. I figured I would hear about it the next day or so. About a week later, one of the people I had tracking Bruce came up to me at lunch with the biggest smile I've ever seen anyone have and proceeded to try not to laugh hysterically as he told me his story. The dean called Bruce out of class into the hallway. My friend sat close to the cracked door and he heard the dean say, "In all of my years of teaching and administration, I have never seen anything like this, but someone has defecated in your backpack." Come to find out, a janitor had found the backpack and brought it to Lost and Found, where it sat for a few days until the smell became horrendous. Finally, they had to go through the Lost and Found and discovered the devastation, and some poor soul had to find a not feces-covered paper to find out whose backpack it was. Bruce never wore a backpack again, and as a result never had the books he needed for class. He failed high school, and last I hear, got hooked on heroin. I ruined his life for wiping Cheetos on my shoulder, and to be honest, I'm proud of it. After having to read this, I feel like this guy should probably go back to school. How do you get away with this after making a threatening statement to his entire friend group and everyone knows you're into prank wars bullshit anyway? My suggestion would be not to use your shit against other people, because that's kind of just begging for someone to do it back. By the way, the author did claim in the comments that this person would smear dog shit under door handles or something. Glad I didn't go to this high school. People are also calling for this to be posted in some place called Reddit Supernova Revenge, so maybe I'll have to go check that out soon. Alright, let's read one more. Cheat on me? Get what you deserve. When I was around 16, I was dating this really cool guy who I had met through a friend. At this time, we were both in the closet, so nobody knew that we in fact began a relationship. Back then I was very low in the self-esteem department, and I'm pretty relaxed when it came to dating. One night I was laying in bed with him since he decided to stay the night. I, unlike him, am a bit of a light sleeper and usually stay up pretty late. I was just about to nod off when my phone notified me of a text. I looked to see it was a mutual friend who I had to admit would be willing to sleep with any man with a pulse. Usually she was the type who liked to tell her friends of her latest conquest. This time she had told me how she slept with my at-the-time boyfriend. It turned out that he took off of work early so he could visit her and they could have sex. This made it worse because he later came to my home and did the same with me. At first I was prepared to slap him and kick him out of the house, but I had a better idea. Slipping out of bed, I searched around my dad's tools, finding a half-empty tube of superglue. I made my way back upstairs by making sure that I unplugged his phone before returning to his side. I continued to glue his manhood to the side of his leg before moving to sleep on the couch the remaining night. I was upset but knew that it would be worth it once he wakes up the next morning. I woke up that afternoon and sat at the table to eat with my unsuspecting parents, enjoying a piece of French toast when I heard a loud thud from upstairs. I couldn't help but grin as my now ex limped down the stairs, most likely preparing to curse me out for what I had done. Of course, my parents were at the table and he did not want to out himself to anyone, nor would he want to face my father about both cheating and sleeping with his only son. He simply grabbed his phone in attempts to phone one of our friends for a ride to find that the battery was dead before choosing to walk his way home. Long story short, I enjoyed my toast before inviting a couple of friends on what was supposed to be a date. We all had a lot of fun, and I ended up coming out to a couple of friends and explained the situation. I later found out that he now has 3 kids from different women. It's not even the revenge that's the best part, it's that he couldn't even tell anyone about it. He must have been so full of impotent rage. Well anyway, that's about all the time I have for you today. Thanks for watching, everyone. Thanks to all my subscribers, and if you're new here and like the content, consider liking, commenting, and subscribing for more of the same. We've got some more classic Something Awful coming up this week, and I'm never too far from making another Nice Guy video, so that's what's in the works right now. Thanks also to my generous patrons, who I'll be shouting out by name on whichever video I think is going to get views. Also, shout out to Gloomy from my Discord. I don't think she did anything, but she did ask for a shout out. That won't work very often, by the way. If you want to join my Discord, it's the best way to get stories to me. I'm planning a viewer-submitted video soon. More importantly, let me know if you enjoyed Nuclear Revenge. I just took a bunch of shorter stories this time, but I'd probably normally cover longer ones. Anyway, have a great day, everyone, and for the love of God, don't leave your backpack unattended.